गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ इंग्लिश ग्रामर बुक एंड द टॉपिक इज वर्ड्स लाइकली टू बी मिसस्पेल्ड। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, देयर आर सो मेनी वर्ड्स इन व्हिच देयर आर मेनी कंफ्यूजन व्हेन वी राइट द स्पेलिंग ऑफ दोज वर्ड्स। व्हेन वी राइट द स्पेलिंग ऑफ दोज वर्ड्स वी आर ऑफन confused to write the meaning, so you have to be very careful to write these words. Just I have written some examples. Just see here, achievement, A-C-H-I-E-M-E-N-T, admission, A-D-M-I-S-S-I-O-N, cigarette, C-I-Z-A-R-E-T-T-A, calling, C-O-L-L-E-A-C-U-A, completion, discussion, D-I-S-C-U-S-S-I-O-N, government, G-O-V-E-R-N-M-E-N-T, mysterious, M-I-S-C-H-I-E-V-O-U-S, performance, P-E-R-F-O-R-M-A-N-T, pneumonia, pneumonia, P-N-E-U-F-O-N-I-A. It will start from P. Vaccine, V-A-C-C-I-N-A-T. So students, in your book, a list of such kinds of words have been given. So you have to read and you have to learn all the spellings very carefully, so that when you have to write such kinds of words, so you may not be confused. Okay? So this chapter is complete. Nothing is given. Only you have to learn the spellings, all the spellings. So you will consult, you will see your book, and you will learn all the spellings. Okay? Students, now see chapter number 32. Idioms. What is an idiom? An idiom is a group of words with a meaning which is different from the usual meaning of the separate words. An idiom is what? It is a group with a meaning which is different from the usual meaning of the separate words. Means an idiom, it has more than one words, okay, and it has the different meaning from the usual meaning of the separate words. Okay, for example, I have written some idioms: rain, cats and dogs. Students, you know the meaning of rain. Well, it will be separate. The meaning of rain will be separate. The meaning of cats will be separate. The meaning of dogs will be separate. The meaning of cat will be separate. But when it will be used as an idiom, then its meaning will be different, and there will be the particular meaning of this idiom, and that is rain and cat. In such a way, a dark horse. It means a person whose abilities are hidden or unknown. Be named and name. Be in close completion. A red letter day. A very important day. By lips and mouths. Means very quickly. A wild chase. Means an useless one. So students, these are idioms. Many idioms are given in your book, so you have not to do anything. You have to learn all the idioms. You have to learn the meaning of all the idioms, because these are very important, very useful in English language. Okay? Students, now see chapter number 33, synonyms and antonyms. These are very easy chapters, easy topics. So I'm telling you 3-4 chapters in a day. Only you have to learn. The list of these synonyms and antonyms have been given in your book. Only you have to learn all these synonyms and antonyms, idioms. Okay? What is synonym? Synonyms are words which have the same or nearly the same meaning. Synonym means the word which has the same meaning. Antonyms are words which are opposite. So some examples I have written: dispute. Synonym of dispute is quarrel. A pentonym brought. Pentonym means the words, pentonym are words which are opposite in meaning. Broad. Pentonym of broad is narrow. The pentonym of high is low. The pentonym of major is minor. The pentonym of able is unable. The pentonym of honest is dishonest. Pentonym of polite is impolite. So, students, a list of synonyms and a list of pentonyms have been given in your book. So, very carefully, you will learn all the synonyms and pentonyms. Okay? Students, now see chapter number 34, words building, formation of nouns, adjectives and verbs. A list of formation of nouns, adjectives and verbs have been given in your book. I have written some examples. Students, there is no particular rules. You have to learn, you have to revise, okay, all these nouns, verb from nouns, noun, verb from nouns, nouns from verbs, okay, adjective from verbs. So see here, forming nouns from verbs. How the formation is, just see here, advertise. It is a verb, it is a verb, then what will be the noun and what is meant? Appoint, verb, appointment. Amuse, amusement. Die is a verb and noun is death. Forming nouns from adjectives. Able, this is an adjective, then what will be the noun? Ability. Bitter, it is an adjective, noun, bitterness. Cruel, it is an adjective, cruelty, noun. True, what is this? An adjective, and true, this is a noun. Next, forming adjectives from verbs. Now, the verbs have been given, and from these verbs, there will be the adjective. Admire, admirable. Marvel, marvelous. Next is forming verbs from adjectives. Civil. It is an adjective, then what will be the verb? Civilize. Past. It is an adjective, the verb will be past tense. So, a list of these nouns, adjective, verbs have been given in your book. So, you will revise, you will learn all those things, all these verbs, adjective, formation of verbs, formation of adjectives, formation of nouns properly. Okay? Students, that's all for today. In next term, I will teach the supplementary reading. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.